We are all church together. We are all faithfully using God's gifts.
Our faith needs to be everywhere.
I believe in connection.
They have the same difficulties we have.
Because our work is for the world.
We don't have to feel alone.
Every dream is possible.
We can grow together.
We are church together.
Hello, my name is Elizabeth Eaton, and I'm the presiding bishop of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America. People often ask me, what's the best part of my job? And I can tell you that it's the chance to go across this church and see you in action. It's wonderful to see how we, touched and transformed by the love of God in Jesus Christ, are trying to make that abundant life known to others. Join me now as we see our story in action, how we are church together, church for the sake of the world. How seemingly ordinary people, used by the love of God in Christ, are able to express and embody that love across this church.
Dear God, thank you for this day that you have given us to be here once more. I pray that you help everyone here understand what Grace in Action is about. And I pray that you protect everyone and that you keep everyone safe. And I pray for all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes when we're thinking about the kingdom of God coming near, it has to be some major production. I don't think anybody would envision a place with lurid green plastic tablecloths, you know, plastic cutlery and all that sort of stuff. This was a holy place tonight. It was just wonderful. What's special or unique about this place? What's the grace of Grace in Action?
Yo creo que lo que hace especial este lugar es la fe. Se lleve más a la práctica que a la lectura. Y por eso me gusta y por eso traigo a mi hijo.
Grace in Action is a bunch of little things, and it's one community moving forward together.
It's a group where we can interact, where we can grow together, where we can let others help us grow.
We teach the Bible by living the Bible. Anyone who comes here feels like they have a voice.
Yeah, we do great things. Develop websites.
Video production, graphic design, and app development. I feel like there's nothing better than connecting with young people in the community.
A lot of people, including myself, have come to this country undocumented and find it really hard to find a place to belong and to be a part of some place like this. Being able to create a community, knowing that you have left a community behind, it's one of the greatest things about Grace in Action.
Claro que ahorita estamos en una situación muy difícil aquí en Detroit, pero este Grace in Action me hace pensar que independientemente de lo que están diciendo, la verdad es que necesitan venir aquí para que vean que realmente estamos haciendo.
For us to be church together is for the rest of the church to understand that Grace in Action is actually a beacon of hope for the rest of us and not just a bunch of clients upon whom we're perpetrating good works. This is the ELCA, and the rest of us as the ELCA are enriched and encouraged by what we're doing here. We as the ELCA are urban parishes, suburban parishes, small town parishes, rural parishes, but we are church together. I had a chance to visit Circle of Faith Parish in Welcome, Minnesota. Circle of Faith is three congregations joined together in shared ministry. One of those congregations is Waverly Lutheran. Waverly decided to reach out to a large city congregation to share their faith and farm life. They chose Gloria Day Lutheran in St. Paul, Minnesota.
We took a moment a few years ago at Waverly and kind of identified ourselves. Who are we? And one of the things that kept coming back is faith, family, and farming. Jesus' parables are so often with farming, and we so often have so much of our heritage is tied into farming and in this church. We have a way of sharing our faith stories, and it's by talking about farming.
The partnership between Waverly Lutheran and Gloria Day began in the summer of 2011. Joe Robbie, who is one of the members of Waverly, came into my office as a complete stranger, sat down and said, "Hi, I am here to talk to you about giving. I am here to give." And I was totally taken aback.
She was taken back and couldn't believe that a small rural parish would even consider partnering with an urban parish.
This complete stranger came and said they had something to give the children of Gloria Day.
What came out of this is something called Sowing Seeds. It's a program for Gloria Day second graders and their families. It teaches about God's creation, stewardship, and farm life. The program wraps up with a trip to Waverly for a harvest festival rich in faith, fun, and sprouting relationships.
One of my favorite moments was the first year we did Harvest Homecoming and the bunch of kids got off the bus. And we had a welcoming committee. There was a ewe and a lamb waiting for them right as soon as they got off. Looks on the children's faces when they got off and saw them and actually got to go up and touch them and pet them.
It shows the gift of how we are all church together. The parents in this one family said to me, you know, it's really wonderful. Another congregation is giving us something. We're always being asked to give. Waverly really acted as the hands and the smiles and the feet and the care of Christ given to us.
As Church Together, one of the things we do is support ministry to seafarers through the work of Lutheran Advocates for Maritime Mission, or LAM. LAM equips local chaplains, advocates for seafarers, and provides ministry resources. Through LAM, the ELCA, all of us accompany chaplains as they reach out to seafarers. These seafarers come from all over the world with families in distant places. Serving them is one part of our commitment to global outreach.
I'm Edward Levy, I'm from Nicaragua. I'm 6 years working in a company. I'm assist the chief engineer.
I'm here for the family.
Yeah, that's where I'm main point. Okay, I have my two daughters, they are still studying, they are in college, so I have to send money to pay for the school fees.
People don't realize how poorly paid the seafarers are. Most of it gets sent home to families. Typically, a seafarer works approximately 9 months out of the year. They have 1 month off at their own expense to be home with their families.
Yeah, I feel lonely sometimes. Yeah, I feel kind of lonely. Yeah, because, you know, a year is too long for me.
We're here to make sure that the seafarer is not a forgotten person and that the church knows that this ministry exists.
Well, I'm in my cabin. I have my books, my Bible, I read anytime I have a little time. Because, you know, sometimes you feel lonely, you got to ask the Lord and, you know, give you strength. And, you know, if we are not with the Lord, things will be more difficult for us.
It's the Lutheran presence with people who maybe not be Christians, because some of the sailors are Muslims, but they know we are there. And they know that if they need something, they can come to us.
Somebody always needs somebody. You always need somebody there to pat you on your shoulder and say, you're important. You're God's child, and God loves you, and we love you, and we appreciate you, because so often they're unappreciated, and it's important that they know that they're loved.
There's no such thing as an individual congregation or member or ministry apart from the work that we all do together in Christ's name. When we see people engaged in Southwest Detroit or in Welcome, Minnesota or in San Juan, Puerto Rico, they are doing our ministry on our behalf because we can't be there. So really, we're one church all across the nation, one church in over 9,000 places. We are Church Together.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Good and gracious God, you've created a marvelously diverse, sometimes complex world, and people who thought they had nothing in common realized that in you, we are all one body. So thank you for the marvelous ways you've surprised us here, and thank you that we realize that yes, we can give, but grace is something that we all need to receive. So bless their work and their ministry, bless their joy and in their trying things new, knowing that as we walk with you, we might stumble, but you won't let us fall. This we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.